My beloved, this morning, God has given me a message that will speak to your heart and prepare yourself to be fire for the Lord. Theme of my message this morning, how to protect your spiritual life. Satan's plan is to destroy your spiritual life. He do everything to stop you walking with God. He do everything to stop the plan of God in your life. But as long as you are strong in the Lord and walking with Him, He will protect you. He will guide you. He will lead you into all truth. Turn with me to Book of Revelation chapter 3. Verses from 14 to 22. There are seven churches in the book of Revelation, beginning from chapter 2. And God, Jesus Christ is speaking to those seven churches. They are little seven churches, but comparing to the whole world church today. And he speaks about the lamb stand in the middle. Star in the middle, stand in the middle of the lampstand, symbolizing Jesus Christ. And in the book of Matthew, chapter 18, verse 20, says, "When two or three are gathered together, Jesus Christ will be in the midst of them." That is also the symbolizing the star in the middle of the seven stands, lampstand, and that is symbolizing Jesus Christ. As He has promised in the book of Revelation, and He also has promised to be with us in the book of Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, in all the Gospels, says that He will be in the midst of us when two or three are gathered together in His name. That is like the star in the middle of the lampstand, seven lampstands. He is standing in the middle of the church. Even this morning He is here. Don't know whether you understand that He is here. If you are in Him, if He is in you, you know that He is in the midst of us. Turn with me to Book of Revelation chapter 3, verses from 14 to 22. "And to the angel of the church of the Lord Laodicea, write these things, says the Amen, the faithful and true witness, the beginning of the creation of God. I know your works, that you are neither cold nor hot. I could wish you were cold or hot. So then, because you are lukewarm and neither cold or hot, I will vomit you out of my mouth. Because you say, I am rich, have become wealthy, and have needed of nothing, and do not know that you are rich, miserable, poor, blind, and naked. I counsel you to buy from me gold refined in the fire, that you may be rich, and white garments, that you may be clothed, that the shame of your nakedness may not be revealed, and anointed your eyes with eye salve, that you may see. Ask many as I love, I rebuke and chasten. Therefore be zealous and repent. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any hears my voice and opens the door, I will come to him and dine with him, and he with me. to him who overcomes, I will grant to sit with me on my throne, as I also overcome and sat down with my Father on his throne. He who has an ear, let him hear what the Scripture says to the churches. My beloved, God is speaking to us through this passage of Scripture as he is speaking to the church in Laodicea those days. Now, the present church, when you compare the seven churches in the book of Revelation, it's included all over the world church together. And also, today, in the present church, as this passage of Scripture says, the church has become lukewarm. How she has become lukewarm? By living an unholy life, and also the church doesn't have a prayer life, no desire for the Scripture, no desire to study the Word of God, no desire to have a fasting and prayers, and reluctant to sacrifice, and they do not want to sacrifice anything other than giving something out of what they have, living a dual life, and speaking behind back. And you may don't like some, if you don't like somebody, if you don't like to meet somebody, when you meet that somebody, you just say, "Nice to see you this morning." That is lying and double tongue, and cheating and lying. You say someone that I'm praying for you always, but you never pray for him. Those are the characters of the people who have a lukewarm life. Lukewarmness is a terrible and horrible sin than the people who live in the world. The people who are in the church, if you are lukewarm, is abomination to God. When you eat something, if your body doesn't want to accept it, you vomit out. And vomiting out means, now God says, if you don't repent and come back, as I'm standing at the door and knock, and he's saying, I'm calling you. I'm calling you like the gold put into the fire and burn and purify and take. I want to purify you with repentance. If not, he said, I will vomit you out from my mouth. It means that we are living in the God's stomach, in other words. We live in him. And if we are not living a holy, acceptable life unto God, he says that he will vomit out. And if he vomit out, you can just shout and praise and worship and singing and praying, all these things will be in vain. Most of our music and our shouting and praising, in the singing we say we sacrifice gold and silver. When it comes to reality, we don't sacrifice anything. Some of the people don't like even to praise God in public. Some of the people don't like even to take the Bible in public. Some of them are ashamed. They are shy to pray in public. It is because they are lukewarm. If you are fire for the Lord, wherever you go, you will exalt the name of God. The name of Jesus. You will live for him. You will be fire for him. My beloved, this morning repent and say, God, forgive me, cleanse me, wash me. As you are knocking at the door, I want to come and have supper with you. And he's waiting till you open the door to come into your heart. And say, Lord, not only the ear to hear, but also let me see you eye to eye with my own eyes. And repent for your weaknesses. Repent for your cheating. Repent for your double tongue. Repent for all dishonesty. If you are lukewarm, you will never be honest. If you are not honest, if you are lukewarm, you will be always a liar and cheating others. Altogether, you are living in sin. But it's acting like a Christian, acting like a God's children, but living a horrible, unacceptable life unto God is an abomination. Therefore, open your heart this morning and ask God to forgive you. Cleanse you with His precious blood and purify you with His blood. And say, Lord, let me have your help to glorify Thy name by living a holy, acceptable life unto God. May God bless you with these few words.